Hello and welcome to Tabletop Warden. I'm Yannick, and this video is part of this month's skill drop, where we focus on how to get started with Song of Ice and Fire. In this video, I will cover a part which is not that often touched on the guild, which is painting. In this video, I will show you how you can paint a Lannister guard, and I think before we start, let's get some basics, what you need for the video. First, of course, the miniatures. Second, you of course need a brush and some paints. We will just use more basic techniques here. So, yeah. Just so, if you don't have painted before, you will you can just paint after this guide, and I think you can achieve good results. And something which we also need is this scalpel or hobby knife, because before we paint, what we will do is look at the miniatures, and you will see here these little lines which comes from the molding process when they make the miniatures. It's it's just normal, nearly every miniature has them, and if we want to paint these miniatures, we don't want these mold lines, so we can just remove them with a knife. Just scrub over them, and if you want to go a bit finer, you can just sand it down, so this line isn't visible anymore, or at least not that prominent. For my miniatures, I only remove these lines on the most prominent parts of the figures, like the head, the helmet, and the shoulder pads. And sometimes I will leave them completely because they won't show up. So just be a bit careful when you remove them to not damage any details on the miniature. Yeah. So after we cleaned these lines up, we will then need to get a ground cover for the paints, which is usually some base paint like a spray paint like this. These spray paints will ensure that your colors will stick, that your paints will stick on the miniatures, which they not they will do, but they won't do it all the time. So just get a spray paint, spray them in a basic color like white or black. I personally prefer white because it's easier to paint later onwards. And yeah, just to make sure that your paint stick on the miniatures. So we need to spray paint them. I won't do it on camera because I don't want my camera to get dirty. So I have got one painted miniature here. And if you spray paint the miniatures, just make sure that you have a little bit of distance, like 30 centimeters or 1 foot, depending on which system you use, and just apply a light coat of paint so you won't lose any details with your spray paint. Yeah, I think now we can get started. With the preparation of the miniatures out of the way, we will start to paint our miniature. What I will use besides my brush and the paints is I use a wet palette. I bought this one, but it's very easy to build one by yourself. You can find tutorials online. And what it basically is, it's just a plastic, small plastic box with the sponge beneath this cover. And then this paper is similar to not wax baking paper or butter bread paper, which isn't waxed because wax will don't allow water to get through the paper, which ensures that your paints stay wet and you get better results of it. But it's not mandatory. I use it because I use it all the time. And if you want to upgrade your setting, you can just build one wet palette by yourself. It's not mandatory, but I prefer it personally. So yeah. So now to the miniatures. We will just go with a basic color scheme here. We will paint is close red, the armor in metallic colors, and the boots and the belt in a brown leathery color, and also the lion and the detail here with the gold. So just basic colors. It's usually the best to just stick to a limited paint range, so you don't get lost in detail. So yeah, now we will start with the flesh tones. I prefer to use Gulliman Flesh. It's the contrast paints from Citadel, which you can just apply on the white, so it makes everything for you. If you don't have a contrast color, you can also go with Raken Flesh Shade here. With Raken Flesh Shade, it's a wash, so you need to apply most often two coats instead of one. So just apply it and also make sure that your color's only at the tip of your brush, so you have more control over your paints. Not like me. That's it. And this color will just darken the recesses and highlights the shadows a bit. It will just have a basic effect, but if you have a regiment of 12 guys, you won't spot the difference between this and a well-established painted mini. So yeah, that's it. For these clothes, we will use the Smithiston Red, as well from Citadel. I only use Citadel in this video. We just shake the color a bit. Apply some color here on the palette. And what you notice is that the color is very thick, which is often the case by miniature colors. So you just get a bit of water on your brush and thin the color a bit down, so you have a lighter coat of color on your miniature, which makes it easier to apply and to work with the color. Now that we apply the basic coat of the color, it's time to paint the recesses. But instead of just doing all of the recesses by its own, we can just use a wash. I use the purple wash here. So we can just apply the wash all over the red color. And after we've done and the wash is dried, it will just go into recesses and get us just darker recesses and a bit more of contrast. but you just need to make sure if you use a wash, you can't let the color pool in a certain position. So you just need to distribute the color a bit more, or just take it away with your brush. After we applied all of the washes, we just need to let the miniatures dry a bit. What is very useful here, if you want to paint a unit of models which look nearly identical or have at least the same clothes or armor, is to just paint more of them at once. So you just repeat the same process over and over again. For example, you could just paint a few more of these models at the same time, so we also can speed up our process, because we don't need to wait until a color is dry, because we're just working on the next miniature. After we applied this wash, we will just go and highlight all the details. For that, we just take our base coat color here. Just twist it a bit that we have a fine tip of the brush, and go to the edges. All the details that need to be highlighted, and just paint the color in again. This is just there to make color a bit more consistent. You can also skip this step if it's too much effort for you. But yeah, just make sure all the parts that we want to highlight afterwards can just go in, just thin the paint a bit. So that's it. We just made sure that everything what we want to highlight later has a more brighter base tone. Oh, you forgot this one. And yeah, just make sure that you pick up the raised parts. And what you also can do is a bit more edgy parts, just paint with the side of your brush, which gives you a bit more control, and just pick out the edges of the model. What we will do next is take a bit of the Wild Rider Red. It's a very bright color. So we have to thin it down a lot. With that, we make sure that we don't apply the color too thick, and so it will have not of a bright impact, and the red underneath will show through a little bit. Just pick up the edges here. Here, just a little. So after this, we declare the clothes were finished. Also, the thing on top, the feather. And yeah, I think it turned out pretty great. You have shadows, purple shadows and recesses, and very bright, a bit more orange highlights at the edges. So yeah, you will have a good distinction between the colors, and yeah, the miniature will pop on the battlefield. So now we have finished the red everywhere. We now will paint the metallics. We will paint the metallics first, because here, for example, are some leathery bits which are over the metallic colors later on. So it will be easier for us to just paint the metallics first and do the leather afterwards. Normally, I would su suggest for you that you paint the leather, so not with normal colors first, before you go to the metallics, because it's easier to paint over normal color than painting over metallics, because metallics have the effect that they often shine through a little, so you need to paint more than one coat of color to cover the metallics completely. So yeah, for now we have Iron Breaker as base coat. We will just paint it all over the armor. Just make sure that you shake the color a lot. Metallics have the metallics often have more pigments than other colors, which will just settle down at the bottom of the bottle, so you won't have the actual color if you just open the bottle. We will do just take a bit of the metallics, put it down onto our palette. Also something you need to make sure is to use an extra pot of water instead of the one we use for the non-metallic colors, because if you have metallic colors in the water, you will have metallic pigments later on in the painting process in the water, so your normal color get a metallic touch, which we don't want. So yeah, just go on and apply all of the metallics onto the miniature. So after we applied the metallic color and after it's dried, we will do nearly the same we did with the cloth. We'll use a wash, in this case a black wash, and just go over all the metal parts to just get a bit more contrast in the recesses. After the wash is dried, we will just take a bit of the Iron Breaker and also get to the highlights and just highlight the armor a bit. After that, we will take Runefang Steel, which is just a brighter metallic. Shake it a bit to make sure that the color evenly distributes in the pot. Take it, twist the brush a little bit, just get to the highlights, highlight them a bit more. At the end, we will just have an armor which has a lot of depth with the wash and also bright highlights where the light can reflect from. So I consider this armor finished for now. What we want to do next is go to the gold parts. Like here, the line on the shield, or the line here, the also on the shield, and the line at the chest of the soldier, also the handle of the sword, which will all be covered in gold. So just to need to make sure to shake the pot again and just apply the base coat. So after we applied the base coat of the gold, we will also wash the gold parts, this time with Acrax Earthshade. It's a bit of a brownish color. You also could do it with Reckon Fleshade, which gives it a bit more reddish color at the end. After the wash is dried, we will now go on and just do first quick highlight with the Retribution armor color from before. After this, we get some Runefang steel, which we already have here on the palette. Just with the brush that we get a very fine line. Just highlight the highest places of the armor with, of the gold with it. So, yeah, that's it with the gold. And after that, we will now go over to the last part of the miniatures, which are all the leather parts on there, which we just paint with a brown base color. Because we don't want it to be too bright, to have too much contrast on the miniatures, we will just use Rhinoxide as our base color. Also use a little bit of water to thin it down a bit to get the right consistency. Yeah, what we will just do is paint all the leather parts, like this strip here. With the base coat of the leather parts finished, we will just get some highlights on the miniature. I will use this Gotthard Brown here. Just get a bit of it, put it on the palette, and thin it down with water. Then just get some highlights onto the boots and also other leather parts. Doesn't need to be that exact because the leather parts are the least visible one because they are the darkest ones. So they are not the focus point of the miniature. That's also the reason why we skip the wash step here. So the miniature is now finished painting. What we need to do next is just paint the base rim and also the base on top and decorate the base a bit. This is very important, at least in my opinion, because you get a really cool effect having your soldiers marching through snow or marching through grassland and so on. So you can unify your army with them all having the same type of base and just let the model look a lot prettier. I personally have all of my miniatures having a black base rim, so I will use this. If you prefer some other colors like browns or grays, you can go on with them. I will just think you should make sure that all of your miniatures have the same color of the rim. So after the base rim is finished, we will go and apply some texture paste on the top. So I have this one. And just make sure that you take an old brush to apply it, because because this paste can ruin your brush if you don't wash it out correctly. So just use an old one, so you can't do anything wrong with it. Now, after we finally have our earth paste on our base, we'll just need to decorate them a bit further. It depends on how you want to design your base, but I love it to have a lot of grass on them, so I use tufts to do this. They are pretty easy to use, and I use these kinds of tufts. What you need to do with the tufts is just pull them from the paper they're stuck on, and then just press it onto the base. And normally they have glue on the back on itself, so you're just there to go. Also, make sure that you mix these tufts so you have more variation in it, so all of your models will look a bit different at the end. So now we're finished, and this is our final result. And I think if you do a lot of them, they will look really nicely onto a unit, onto a unit tray, also if they're fully designed on the base. And I think it's pretty easy to use, and also if you do more than one, you can get results pretty quickly, so you don't need that much time then painting each miniature individually. So just repeat the step on all of your miniatures, for example, three or four miniatures, I would recommend for you. So yeah, I think it's a fast process and you get a really cool result. And yeah, don't be shy to make something wrong. You can always go back and repaint some parts. So yeah, I hope this helps you starting to paint miniatures, and we see you in the next video. Bye.